Hey guys, Dave from Wellsby Roots. Out in the shop today, and I'm out here with my Cold Steel Trailhawk. I got this for Christmas this year. So, you guys know I like to do projects, so it's a pretty cool little hawk you can see here. But it is ugly. They got their sticker on there. These do not come sharp at all. They are pretty dull, so obviously that's going to need some work as well. But we're going to do lots of work to it. I'm going to fancy this right up, make it pretty. So that's what we're going to be doing today. So first things first, I'm going to take the head off this. Comes with a bolt in it, so I need my Allen keys, wherever they are. Okay, so the Allen key is metric, so you want to take a bolt out of the Cold Steel Trailhawk, you need a metric Allen key. So we'll set that aside. Put that away, and that's up there pretty good. Let's see if we can tappy tap. There she is. You can see that they paint the hawks. We're going to be taking that off as well. The handle, it's hickory. It comes pretty rough. So that's going to need to be sanded down a little bit. See, a lot of the guys complain about these coming with a varnish on them, but this one doesn't seem to have any varnish. This is just straight up wood, no protection on it at all. So I'll give that a little bit of a sand because it is kind of rough. Smooth it out a little bit, and then we're gonna be sanding it. So anyway. Onto the head. I'm just going to use a little bit of sandpaper, fine grit. Start off with 150 because I don't want to muck up the steel at all. And I'm just going to do it by hand. I should take it off. Let's take the sticker off. Probably have to sand it off. Why you stick a sticker on there? But anyway. Better already. Anyway, I'm gonna continue to sand off this paint, and when I'm done, I'll get back to you. All right, guys. So I finished sanding the tomahawk head. You can see it here, and you can see that the steel underneath the paint is a little rough. You can see that a little better. At one point, I was considering using a wire brush on my grinder and taking the paint off quick. And I'm really glad that I didn't, because my original plans after taking the paint off was to force patina on it. But I've since changed my mind. I really like the way it came out. What you're seeing there is what's left of the paint in all the little crevices. And that paint will help protect it. But I'll also put some steel protection on it myself. Keep it from rusting. But I don't know, I really like the way it came out. I really like the way the head looks. I haven't finished sanding the handle yet. I'm still working on that. But I don't know. I'm really liking that. So I hope you guys can see it. I know the camera never does it justice, but I'm really liking the way that turned out. I think it looks 10 times better. So there's the head. Done. So I'm going to finish sanding the handle, and then we're going to stain it with some homemade stain. The vinegar and steel wool stain that I made. We're going to stain it with that and see what the outcome is like. I'm gonna just do a little bit on the end to see how it turns out, see what coloration I get. And if I like it, then we'll do the whole handle. And I'll take you guys along when I do that. So, sanding down the handle here, there's a couple spots that I'm going to take off. Here's one on the very top, and then this is the very bottom. And this would have been where the lathe would have been connected on it, I believe, anyway. So we're just going to take that off because I don't like it. So we're just going to cut it off a little bit and see how it works. Alright guys, so basically finished sanding her down. Yeah, the end done's. Yeah. Okay. And I didn't clean her up like 100%. I just kind of sanded it down and get it smooth and take out some of the rough edges, but I want it to look a little bit rough. So and it's gonna get used anyway, so it's gonna get beaten up. basically, I just wanted to get out some of the really rough edges and some of the marks and stuff like that. So, and if there was anything on it, I wanted to get that off as well before I tried to stain it. Might cause color differ if there was anything from the factory on it. Spills, anything like that. So, give it a quick sand and clean it off with the cloth. Get all that sawdust off of it. And we're going to take our concoction of vinegar and steel wool, and I'm going to use a cloth to stain it. I'm just going to dip it into the steel wool. Okay, I'm doesn't want to sit still. Anyway. So I'm just going to take my cloth and dip it in. And I'm just going to do a test area. I'm going to do a test area up here where the hawk is going to sit. Just to see what it might look like when it's stained. It may take a couple coats to do it, so. We get. Alright guys, so I'm happy with the handle. I'm happy with the hawk itself, the head. And so I want to add one final thing. For now anyway. We'll see. I'm looking at my deer antlers and contemplating different things, but for now anyway, I'm gonna be adding some leather, the leather that I was working on. So I'm basically happy with the color of it. It's basically dry, basically, and, we're going to be adding that around the neck, just to top it off. I think it looks sharp. So, basically, I'll bring you down here so you can see what I'm doing. What I'm going to do is, and I've actually already done it, so I'm going to take my leather, and I'm going to wrap it around the neck, like so. And I'm going to mark it approximately here and here. Okay. We're going to flip it around. And we're going to mark it again here and here. Just on the edges. Just basically where this bevel here comes down. Okay. So then what we're going to do is... we're going to take the head off. And I know that this side here was on this side of the leather. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of trace it a little bit. So we'll trace that, and then we'll flip it over, and we'll do the same on the other side. And this may not be perfect, we might have to touch it up a little bit as we go about. I mean, you can't really see what I'm doing, can you? So basically what I did was I took this and I put it here and I'm kind of feeling out. You could probably put it underneath too, but basically going to come out the same if you feel it out. And I'm going to kind of cut away a little bit, and I'm not going to cut out too much. I'm going to cut out a little bit at a time, and because I mean, you can always take more away, but you can't add, right? So here we're going to I cut this a little bit. We'll see. We'll put it back on and see how it fits. I'm going to cut on the inside of my line. Head back on. Put this back up. See what we need to do. So I think we need to trim this up a little bit here. We're going to have to do a little bit more dyeing when we're done. It's not a bad fit. Might want to take just a little bit out of here. See if we can just cut a little bit out of here. It's a fairly decent fit. You can see it there. So it's a pretty good fit. And then all we're going to do is we're going to take some black black thread, and we're going to stitch it all the way down here. And I'll get back to you on that one in just a second. So you can see here, I'm getting a reaction, obviously. Anywhere the wood's soft, it's turning it a dark gray almost. It's giving it a very, very weathered look. Kind of like an aged look. I know the camera doesn't do it justice. You can't really see it. I'm not 100% sure that I'm happy with that. So I'll continue on with it and see how it goes. I might have to do some sanding afterwards. And I don't know. I like the way it turned out on the stir stick. With the pine, this is a stir stick. I'm almost 100% sure they make them out of pine, but with the pine, turned out a real nice dark brown. And like I said, all the every type of wood that you apply this to, it's gonna come out a different color because of the tannins in the wood. So from my understanding, anyway. So every time you apply it, it's going to be different. You can see here just the different colorations, and you can see here where I dipped the stir stick in and one time, and then dipped it in again, and it didn't go in as deep. So you can see even the coats, the amount of coats that you give it will determine what color it's going to be. So, and you can see the definite difference in the different two different types of wood here. So, but anyway, I will continue on with the staining process, and I will give you guys an update how it's going and what direction I take. All right, guys. So, so you can see here, it's not entirely dry, but you can see here, or maybe not. The color that it turned out, it's a very, very grayish look. It looks the equivalent of something you would find on a beach. So something that's been very, very, very weathered, been in the sun, been exposed to, you know, maybe sea salt, something along those lines. But it's very weathered. This side's got some white spots still. So you can see they light up. It might be a little bit more lit up once I add some beeswax maybe to it. We'll see. But at first I really was not impressed with the coloring at all. I usually tend to lean towards more dark brown. I just like it. But I threw the head on. I don't know. I'm kind of liking it. With the head and with the aged wood, I'm really liking it. I think that once I add the leather around the handle, I'm gonna drop some leather down just about here. I actually already cut the piece. Once I add the leather onto it, the leather's gonna be dark brown. I think it's going to look good. So we'll see. That's what doing projects is all about. Get the head off. Anyway, so the leather, I took a piece of cow leather that I had. And right now I'm just prepping it. I'm actually using some dye prep. So right here. Some dye prep. And I already have some of my cloth. Basically, you just rub the dye prep into the leather. And it basically opens the leather up. And gets it to the point where it's going to absorb the leather dye. It'll actually suck it up and then dye the leather. This is really simple. All we're going to be doing with this is wrapping it around the handle, and I will contour it so that it fits the head here. I want to make it nice and tight right up against there, and that will be, like I said, be a dark brown, so I think it will look sharp. But anyway, I'm going to continue doing this. I'll get back to you in a minute. Alright guys, our leather is ready to dye. I did a little test patch. Basically, all you're going to do is your leather should come with a little swab, and you're just going to run it along the leather, and you can see it's very light brown right now, but the more coats that you do, the darker it will get. Which is a good thing, because then you can choose how dark you want it to be. So when it reaches the darkness you want it, you just stop putting coats on. You want to be careful, because streaks and spots, like up here, they'll stain that way. You can usually rub them out. Any real thick spots, where the leather, or where the dye, sat, can usually be rubbed out too. Any little nicks, scratches, anything like that, it's going to be darker than the surrounding areas. Just to give you a heads up. But this is supposed to look rough. I want it to look rough, so I don't really care about that. If you're doing something nice, say like a knife sheath, something like that, you'd want to take more caution with it, but with this, I don't really care. So, and then the edges, all around here, these will come out really dark, because it's being absorbed right into the leather. It's easy to absorb. In those areas, and I'm actually not going to put any dye on the back, because it's just a waste of dye. You can't see it anyway, so there's no point. But you want to make sure you get enough of it so that camera cut out. When you're doing the edges, you want to make sure you get enough of it so that nothing's exposed. But so anyway, it's almost dry, so I want to do another coat. Do another coat, get it a little bit darker. I like my leather dark. So I'm just going to continue to do coats until I get it at the right color that I want it to be. I'll get back to you guys when I'm done.
So now I'm just trying to figure out where my stitching is going to go. Basically got this here, and then I drew a line down down the edge here, and basically gonna do the same on this side here. I'm just gonna give it a really good pinch, and then I know it's hard to see what I'm doing, just a really good pinch, and then I'm just gonna put a pencil mark right there.
And then use my my square here to draw the line all the way down.
And the thread that I'm going to be using is a nylon thread. It's the same stuff they use for sewing couches and such together. I'm going to be using a hole punch to a leather punch to make my holes. I got it on the smallest setting. And I'm just going to mark my holes out now.
I'm going to be using what I believe is called a saddle stitch. I'm going to stitch it, then come back on it so it looks like one solid line. And
I always get in the way of the camera, sorry. But it makes it a lot more solid. I like the aesthetics of it, the way it looks when it comes back on itself. That solid line. And even if you didn't come back on itself, man, that the thread that I'm using is just, it's almost indestructible. All right. So I'm just going to put these two together like so. Try to match up the lines. Looks pretty close there. Yeah. And see if we can punch through both sides at one time, just to kind of move things along. Sounds like we got it. It's nice. Nice. It's a good size hole. So anyway, I'm going to continue on with my my punch, and I'll bring you back, guys, back when I'm ready to do the stitching. So my holes are punched, and I changed my mind. I'm going to use this waxed cotton that I have to sew it together with. So I'm just going to stitch her up, and we'll see how it goes. This dye is not completely dry. It's staining my hands. But sometimes it's a miracle that my projects work out at all.
Anyway, I'm going to finish stitching this up, and I'll get back to you guys. Alright guys, one more thing I'm going to do to the handle, just because aesthetics aside, you know, you want it to look a certain way, blah blah blah, I do want to take care of it, so we're going to use some linseed oil, just to give the wood a little bit of moisture, because I'm really not sure, the vinegar and steel wool mixture, the homemade wood stain, I'm not sure if it will dry out the wood and how badly. As far as that's concerned, I don't have any experience with that, so I'm gonna coat it in linseed oil, and I'll do that once a week for a month, and then I'll do it one time. It doesn't look that bad, actually.
The camera can't pick it up. No, it doesn't.
But, yeah, I'll do it once a week for a month. And then after that, I'll do it once a month. And then once a year. Just to make sure that it doesn't dry out on me. And take care of your tools, and they'll always be around to perform. And it looks a little better with the linseed oil on it. Brightens it up just a little bit. But yeah, I'll do that again tomorrow. Put a little bit more where the leather is going to be, because I won't be able to get at that where the head's going to be in the leather. I'll give a little bit extra coat. So that should be good for now anyway. I suppose I could always slip the leather back off if I wanted to. I suppose I could do that. So let's put this back on. Nice and snug. This is basically done drying. See if we can slip the leather sheath on. It's a tight fit, but that's what we want. It's good. It's pretty good. I might trim this up a little bit, but I don't know. I'm kind of liking this tail end here. It doesn't interfere really with anything. It might once I make the sheath for it. I'm playing around with some ideas in regards to that. I might not make a typical sheath just for the hawk. The sheath I'm thinking about would be kind of unique, so I'll save that for another video if the day comes about. But anyway, there you go. That is my mod to my Cold Steel Trailhawk. All done. Just needs to dry up. So, again, hope you guys enjoyed the video. And I haven't pasted it together yet. See how long it is. Hopefully it's not too long. But you know, it takes time to do these projects. So, leave your comments and suggestions. For those of you guys that have Cold Steel or any hawks for that matter. It doesn't have to be Cold Steel. There are some really, really nice hawks out there. What do they call themselves? Two Hawk? They make some gorgeous hawks, if that's the correct name for the company. I can't remember. But they make beautiful hawks. I just can't afford them right now. So this is an excellent substitute. Yeah, leave comments, likes, dislikes. If you're not a subscriber, subscribe, or I will come after you with my Cold Steel. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.